obviously start playing next week, which they can achieve by getting just one tonight, Dan. Just one.
That's all they need. Easier said than done for the last few games for the Canadians. McDavid on it again. Nurse, snapshot off a stick, and that'll rattle wide as it broke the stick of Lehkonen. He's got a new one. He's got the puck from
that
Evans.
That feels awfully long for him.
Here comes Evans. Stomping. Shoot. Scores! Bullseye from Jake Evans. His first goal in 41 games, and it's 1-0 Montreal.
Heady play on the bench. Someone gets the stick to Arturi Lehkonen. It's not his own, I don't think, but he's able to go give and go. And Jake Evans, how about the stop up on Darnell Nurse? That is a beautiful decision. You got to sell your going wide. When he reaches, you jack on the brakes.
Gonna feel great for him. His first since January the 21st. And the Canadians get on the board first. There's Chiasson. He's got a man in front. McLeod. Now Neal tries to shove it. He scores. James Neal from a sharp angle. And the Oilers, just like that, have tied the game and won. Well, the Canadians looking kind of shoddy in their own zone on that play.
Helmets this year is back in the lineup. And you're right. It's broken coverage because you see Merrill trying to get back to the front of the net. He actually sticks himself in the stomach with a stick. It's a stick caught up in the side of the net, and he can't get to McLeod. That is not the defensive coverage you're looking for, and not the response you want for a shift after a goal when you want to be rock solid.
20 seconds between goals, the fifth goal of the year.
Look
for
out.
Neal. Here he is again. He rang it off the goal post.
Look out.
James Neal with a fortunate bounce, and he almost gave the Oilers the lead.
Harry tries to go up to the middle of the ice, and you have to be so careful. He finds a stick and a skate, and James Neal throws on the place. Quick release. Puts it down, flicks it on net, has Jake Allen beat. For the goaltenders, it's really turned into a pretty serviceable player for the Edmonton Oilers.
Long pass for Dreisaitl. He'll leave it. Yamamoto walks in, had the stick lifted. They score. Nugent Hopkins picks up the loose puck. And it's 2-1 Edmonton.
Can play it, but it's still a clean 3-on-2, and that is bad deep neutral zone play. You can't give up a clean rush like that. It's Corey Perry who ends up lifting Yamamoto's stick right there. Slides over Nugent Hopkins.
13 shots to 9 advantage in that first period of play. A couple of Canadians that didn't see a lot of ice. Josh Anderson, 342. Kotkaniemi played 246.
Wow.
Tatar just under 4 minutes.
Those guys that have more than a 9-minute pace.
Canadians, Caulfield walks it out, tries to shoot, gets it back, and that shot stopped there by Koskinen. He's banned on it, but didn't lose track of it. So they had that one good look with Toffoli in the left circle, but not much else. Now Evans calls for it, makes a nice move around Dreisaitl. His pass, Lehkonen out front. Here's Byron, scores! Paul Byron with a beautiful finish, and the Canadians have tied it at 2. And how good has this line been, Mike?
They get the job of coming out at the end of a power play. Knowing that's going to be McDavid and Dreisaitl, but there you see the step by Evans. That's the play where it happens. You got to have some confidence and some poise and some skill to make that hard cut to Paul Byron. This is a nice little backhand roof jobby as well. 2 on the night and lots of chances.
They all have 2 points each, and here they come again. Evans for Lehkonen. Backhands it off the stick of Nurse. Turning, Byron shoots, and a good save by Koskinen as Byron looked for his second goal in short order.
Rust whatsoever. Speed and tenacity, stopping on pucks.
Jones will turn and put it into the corner. And grabbed by Cahoon. He'll send that through the blue ice. Canadians can't get possession now. Connor McDavid cutting on Tatar. McDavid out front. Nice pass. And Cahoon scores. McDavid quiet until then, but a terrific play. And the Oilers have the lead again. It's 3-2.
McDavid just dropped Tatar with a hard cut inside, and there's nothing Tatar can do with it. At that point, you got to recognize, okay, we don't have the legs. We can't isolate anybody on McDavid. Just collapse back and let them shoot from the outside, because what a play this is. He's looking for Cahoon's stick the whole time.
Black comes down low and grabbed there by McDavid. He's got Nugent Hopkins who hollers for it, picks it up. Suzuki trying to bottle up McDavid. He can't to the net. Tipped and stopped there by Allen. Side of the net, Nugent Hopkins. He can't get a crack at it.
What, 8 games left?
Perry chops it, 20 seconds left. Stahl tries to jab it in a couple of times. He's knocked down. It comes back to Kulak. Jeff Petry with a drive, and that is blocked by the left hand. It looked like Kara as he shook it off. They really have, and as mentioned earlier, Byron with his first assist on the on the Evans goal. Should say his assist on the Evans goal. Point 200 in his career. Now Stahl as the third period gets underway. Now McDavid threw it to the front of the net right on the stick of Evans. A 3-on-2 developing right side. Byron with speed. Evans takes a look at him. Gets it through. Byron for luck and it scores!
Top of their own circle. What a play by Jake Evans. Make sure everyone's outside. And the backhand touch for Pauly Byron. I love it. I just love the look.
Yeah, I said it.
I said make sure everyone's onside. It's hard for Lekkonen and Byron. They can't slow down that much or else the rush is ruined. You have to time it. Now, you don't challenge these unless you know the answer.
Determined the play was offside.
Ah, there it is.
Goal. We need to reset the clock at 16:35.
All right, so does it, to this the problem. See, Larson's forcing him to pull it now. Now remember, guys, new rule.
Hacked by Sherratt. Quick shot by Larson. Nugent Hopkins had some space in front, releasing his Anderson. And he's got a break. Following up is Larson. Anderson right in. Good save by Koskinen with the right skate. Watching Molson Export Canadiens Hockey on TSN. Edmondson, all the Oilers get back. Shot in behind the net. Koskinen. Larson, cut off there by Perry, swung it out to the front of the net. Here's a chance for Anderson, and Koskinen got the paddle down. Petrie was in there too. Evans, his pass, it'll come to Sherratt with a drive. That's blocked by Jones, and he flips it over the head of Cahoon and out. Evans curling and leaving it. They're onside this time. Arturi Lekkonen scores! Arturi Lekkonen with a heavy snapshot, and he ties this game at 3. That one's going to count.
Quick transition play. Flipped out here. But again, it's Jake Evans stepping off the boards, making the nice play. And then that's a terrible goal. I mean, Lekkonen gets rewarded for a strong game. But that is just a flat-out awful goal.
It's been a long time coming for the Canadiens. They are going to get the single point they need and clinch a playoff spot as we're through 60 minutes of play and tied at 3. Canadians in overtime this year, 3-6. The Oilers, they've only been to overtime 4 times all year. Not been to a shootout. Aerial feed. Now hustling is Yamamoto. They keep it onside. Yamamoto sets it up. Barry hits the goal post. And that fires off the glass. He had a lot on that shot.
A short side slapper as he beats his man up the ice. And he's Jake Allen, but catches almost post crossbar where they connect. Look at this. That is right off the toe of his stick.
Couldn't adjust quickly enough. Now the Oilers up by Nugent. Hopkins shoots. Stopped by Allen. And hanging out at center ice was Caulfield as it's grabbed and held there by Jake Allen. On comes Tatar. Here comes Caulfield. Shoots, and that rattles off Nurse. Caulfield plays it to the corner. Tatar first on it, but he gave it away to Dreisaitl. McDavid is up ahead. Connor McDavid looking behind, but he'll walk it alone, and he scores. McDavid wins it in overtime for the Oilers, and they take it 4-3.
As if, where's Darnell Nurse? I want to drop it to him on a 2-on-0. No, I guess I'll take the breakaway myself. We've seen this a million times. You have to cheat on his backhand because he skates so fast and handles it so quickly. So you get low and you get moving laterally, and then he pulls it back and quick little flick up to the short side, and another game winner.